ACMi is working with the Cyrus Dallin Art Museum to piece together a major project which focuses on one of Arlington's favorite sons, the world-renowned sculptor Cyrus E. Dallin. In recent weeks, we have been producing an oral histories program. Area residents reading firsthand accounts of people who came in contact with this master artist and have a fascinating story to tell everybody. Here's a sample of our project about a young girl who knew Cyrus Dallin as a kind neighbor, not as a superstar in the artistic community. It's a memory that she now has for keeps.
Was a former resident of Ashland Road in Arlington Heights and was living in New Pond Village in Walpole, Massachusetts, the day she visited the Cyrus Dallin Art Museum with her daughter, Judy Scherzo of New Jersey. That was in April 2002. Since she did not want to be filmed, the museum recorded her recollections of the time she lived in Arlington and her memories of Cyrus beginning in the early part of 1919 when her family moved here. Bernice remembered distinctly about Cyrus and his shooting his large bow and arrows into the field across the street from his house on Oakland Avenue. She and her family lived on Ashland Road, which is above Oakland Avenue, and so it was natural for children in the neighborhood to observe Cyrus with his big bow, and he offered it to anyone who would like to try it out. It was as big as a man. I can still hear the bow twang, she recalled. Bernice said that Dallin was friendly and very outgoing. Children were always invited to his studio. She said, "I was very shy and my friends were not interested, so we never went. In retrospect, I think, how could I not have done that? I didn't know he was famous. He was just a nice neighbor as far as I knew." She remembered going to the Locke School on Paul Revere Road in Arlington Heights. "I remember our fourth grade in the assembly hall. I don't remember Cyrus being there, but there were several statues on the stage. After the Locke School, I went to the Junior High West. I was in the first class to go all the way through the school from the seventh grade. I graduated from there in 1926 and from Arlington High School in 1929. Bernice said, "I remembered Ashland Road had a steep slope, perhaps 19 degrees. Once when the town wanted to buy a new fire engine, they brought it up to our street to test it, make sure it could navigate the hill, since there are so many hills in Arlington Heights. In the winter, we went sledding down Ashland Road through yards, streets, and embankments. We didn't have to worry about cars. We could also ski down. We'd have to sit down to stop before reaching Paul Revere Road, which was very busy with cars." Bernice recalled, "Gray Street was a wonderful place to coast, though it was too long a walk back. So although we could do it, we didn't go as far as Menotomy Pond. We had flexible flyer sleds in all sizes, not only in the winter, but in all seasons. We didn't go home until the street lights turned on. On occasion, there were some bad accidents. I recall someone was killed sledding down Appleton Street. For entertainment in the days before television, radio, and cell phones, we played games, talked, sang, and danced. My high school graduation present was a wind-up Victrola record player. Kids came from school walking or went to scout meetings. We played games like charades, hide-and-seek. We were busy all the time. We also roller skated on Elmore Street. During April, we would make May baskets for everyone, filled with jelly beans and cookies and decorated with crepe paper, and secretly left them on doorsteps. We would go into town and get banana splits from the drugstore for a nickel." Bernice said, "It was a different life now. She remembered one Christmas her father brought home a radio, and her uncle was standing in the living room trying to explain to all his kids how it worked, how those voices got in there. We put our first crystal radio in a big bowl to make it louder." She paused for a few moments and said, "The town seems to have grown up."
Our Arlington is so fortunate to have this museum right here in town at 611 Mass Ave. Few museums on the globe are located in the town where the artist actually lived and where he worked. We are among the select few. To get more information on this upcoming series or all the events occurring at the Cyrus Dallin Art Museum this summer, just go to the museum website, dallin.org. Again, that website for the museum, dallin.org.